Hello and welcome back to Medmont's M700 tutorial videos. In this video, I'm going to discuss the test window home screen in more detail, as well as the basics of the editing tab and the various ways you can modify a test while it's running. To get started, press the perimeter exam button and select your instrument if you don't already have a default set. The first thing you should notice is that the majority of the test window is filled with the representation of your perimeter, showing all of the points that make up the testable field. Points shown as a small black circle with a number inside are stimulus locations that will be tested in the current test. Points shown as light gray with no numbers will not be tested. The numbers displayed in the center in blue are the starting exposure levels in decibels. These starting values are based on either the patient's previous exams or the age normal hill of vision. As such, make sure when you're testing a new patient that their age is correct, or it may take longer to find the correct thresholds. I'm going to quickly start this exam, and you'll see how the different numbers change. Notice that at the beginning, the blind spot is tested even with video fixation monitoring turned on. With the exam paused, you can see that so far, of the points that have been tested, each one is now red, green, or white. I'm currently controlling the patient switch, and I have only indicated that I've seen one point. The numbers shown in red are points that have previously been exposed, but not seen at that level. The numbers shown in green are points that were seen at their last exposure, and points in white have already completed, and the number is the threshold value that they've completed at. For example, this point that says no was exposed at the brightest level and still not seen, so it completed at a not seen value. If I start the test again, you can watch the other points complete. The stimulus points are arranged in concentric circles, with radii starting at 1 degree, and extending out through 3, 6, 10, 15, 22, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, and 80 degrees. If you glance at the bottom left corner, you can see a simplified representation of what these rings are. An important point to be aware of is that the 60, 70, and 80 degree rings are in reference to an eccentric fixation point, which requires the patient to shift their fixation either to the left or the right. When asking a patient to change fixation, you may want them to slightly tilt their head in the direction of the fixation target, as well as shifting their gaze. I'm going to stop this test and start a new exam now. We've already looked at the patient and exam panels in previous videos, so let's get started with the test panel. The test panel gives you the option of a slow and a fast button. The test will start with the fast option selected, but if you notice that your patient is having a hard time responding to stimuli in time, you can press the slow button to give them additional time to respond. Of course, tests will complete quicker if you're using the fast button. The stimuli presentation is adaptive and will speed up if the patient is responding quickly. This can assist in reducing the testing time. Above the speed controls is a drop-down box containing all of the available test templates. It starts out with only the pre-built templates included in Medmont Studio, but any test that you build and save for yourself will also be added to this list. The next panel you'll notice is the eye panel. Here, you can select which eye you want to test. Medmont will default to the right eye each time you open the test window. If you're running a binocular test, this option will be unavailable, as both eyes must be selected. If you're testing the right eye, put the occluder over the patient's left eye and their chin on the left side of the chin rest. Wind the chin rest up until the patient's iris is centered in the video window, which is in the bottom left of the screen. In the left corner of the panel, you can select the box for multiple targets to display a four-point set of fixation targets. This can be used for patients with a macular defect. You would instruct them to center their defect within the 4 points. There's also the auto blind spot option, which you can check on or off. If you look down in the left corner above the video fixation panel, you'll see the blind spot fixation monitoring panel. This displays all of the possible blind spot stimuli in light gray, with the current selected blind spot location in dark gray. With auto blind spot turned on, if the patient sees the blind spot stimulus while fixating correctly, Medmont Studio will automatically select and try other stimulus points to determine the location of the blind spot. With this option turned off, the technician is responsible for selecting the blind spot location, which you can use by clicking on different stimulus locations. However, you should be careful about turning this feature off, as the test will continue even if the blind spot is not correct, and can compromise your test reliability and repeatability. If you click on the fixation drop-down menu, you also have the option to move to video fixation. This will speed up your test by removing the need to test the blind spot and reducing the number of exposures in the test. It can also ensure a better quality test, as fixation is continuously monitored, and points that are exposed during a blink or loss of fixation will be retested. For patients that have a hard time maintaining fixation, you can select relaxed video tolerance, which allows for slightly more leeway in eye movement, but also may reduce the reliability of the test. Please be aware that to ensure the best results for video fixation monitoring, the patient must wear the supplied eye patch for monocular testing or the headband for binocular testing. These must be worn correctly or they will not function well, with a central black target located above the nose and not higher on the face than just above the eyebrows. You can see pictures of the correct positioning in our M700 quick setup guide, which was included with your M700. One more feature in the top panel that we haven't discussed is the demo button. When you press the demo button, the test will begin in a demonstration mode. This appears the same as a normal test to the patient, but none of the data is stored. It can be useful for showing your patient how the instrument works and what they can expect. I'm going to swap over to an exam using the simulator so I can run this exam while I'm talking. If you look at the test status box on the left, you'll see data that updates as the test progresses. Everything is currently set at 0 until the test starts. The complete monitor shows the number of stimulus points that have fully completed. The fixation loss monitor shows the number of times that fixation has been lost as a percentage of the amount of times it has been checked. With blind spot monitoring, this is a function of the number of times the blind spot has been exposed, which occurs at about every 10 exposures. Video fixation monitoring continuously updates throughout the test. False positive and false negatives are important in determining the reliability of the patient you are testing. A false positive occurs when a patient indicates they've seen a point that was not displayed. This often occurs when the patient is simply responding to the rhythm, or they're trigger happy. High rates of false positives may indicate your patients need more training and some extra practice. On the other hand, false negatives occur when a patient fails to respond to a bright exposure in a point where the threshold is already known. This may be an indicator of patient fatigue, or that they're just not paying attention anymore. The response monitor is based on the response time that is set for the test. If you've selected adaptive response, this may change throughout the test as Medmont Studio adapts to your patient's speed. The exposures monitor shows the total number of exposures that have been shown to the patient, and the time monitor gives an indication of how much time has elapsed since the test began. The strategy listed at the bottom will not change as the test progresses, and it shows which testing strategy the test is using. If we start the test, you can watch the test status indicators update. You can see that the blind spot is checked first to ensure the patient is fixated correctly to begin with. As each point is tested, you can see the exposures number incrementing upwards. You can also see that at about every 8 to 12 points, the blind spot is tested, and the fixation loss status also updates. If this were a real test with video fixation, the blind spot would not be checked. You can try the simulator out on your own and watch how everything updates. Now is where things get a little more fun. While the test is running, you still have a lot of control. If you click on the Edit tab in the top left, you'll see the option to add and retest points. If we take a look at this test, which has continued to run, we see what looks like a defect. If you want to explore the surrounding area to see the extent of the defect, all you have to do is click on the points you're interested in and press Add. You can see that these points are now ready to be tested in real time. Similarly, you may find a defect that looks suspicious and wonder if it's just a patient error. No problem, just select the point and press retest. Medmont Studio will incorporate that point back into its testing program. These options to add and retest are also available at the end of the test without restarting it. Just add the points you're interested in and press the start button to complete the test. You'll notice that the software will include a couple of points from outside your selected points to give the illusion that this test is random. Now that the test is completed, and you've tested the additional points you're interested in, you can either analyze the test immediately, or save it. Press on Save to store the test under whichever patient you have selected, or click Analyze to take a look at the results first. To test the other eye, simply click on New. This will change the exam over. Be sure to patch the patient's other eye, move them onto the other side of the chin rest, and align them correctly. Click Start to perform a test when you're ready. Okay. This is where I'm going to end the tutorial for now. You can find out more about analyzing results in a separate video, and I hope you'll follow along. Thanks for watching.